Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me today from Harbor Custom Development is CFO Lance Brown. Lance, good to meet you. How are you today?
I'm doing great, Christine. Thanks for speaking with me today.
Of course. Yeah, great to have you on. Exciting news as yesterday Harbor announced its first quarter earnings for the year. Can you tell us some of the highlights from the call?
Yeah, sure. So we had another strong quarter for the first quarter of the year. We achieved another record top line sales quarter, coming in at approximately $28.6 million. And we had a new Q1 record in terms of net income at $1.6 million for the quarter. And then on a year-over-year basis, we saw significant favorability really across all the major P&L categories, from revenues to gross profits, gross margin, operating expenses as a percentage of sales, operating income, net income, EBITDA, and adjusted EBITDA. So really across the board.
Congratulations on that for sure. What do you think contributed to growth during the quarter here?
Yeah, I think, a lot of this comes down to being in the right place with the right products at the right time. As you know, we operate in some of the strongest markets in the country, and there's a real supply and demand imbalance right now. Demand is at record highs, and single and multifamily inventory levels are at historical lows. And so, that's causing some market issues. But I think one of the things that Harbor's done really well over the last 12 months or so is continue to acquire and develop our real estate assets. So we've grown that asset base significantly. And what that's done for us is allow us to meet some of this demand and continue to grow in terms of top line revenue and increase our overall market share.
And besides some of the financial metrics here, what other kind of growth did you see here?
We moved to a new office space in Tacoma, Washington recently, and that's really allowed us to continue to expand our growth initiatives. We closed a senior secured revolving credit facility for $25 million with Bank United in the first quarter. And that has provided us additional liquidity and financial flexibility to support the current growth initiatives we have and future growth initiatives. We recently entered the Texas market, and that's been going very well. We closed on two new home sales in the month of March with sales prices of approximately $400 per square foot. And we have another nine homes under contract in Texas that we expect to close later in the year. And then in terms of our multifamily offerings, we recently announced the listing of six properties in the Western Washington area for $278 million. So lots of exciting things happening.
Yeah, you mentioned Texas, California, and your entrance into Washington as well. How has that been received so far?
Yeah, it's been very well received. We've received a lot of positive feedback, and we've seen some movement in stock price over the last few days, and our trading volume in terms of common shares has increased significantly over the past couple of weeks. We've also recently seen some voluntary conversions of our preferred shares and exercises of some of the HCDIZ warrants. So a lot's happened with that.
However, we are seeing declines in the market kind of across the board affecting most companies. So do you anticipate to have a stock buyback anytime soon?
Yeah, that's a great question. We haven't had any recent announcements for any kind of new stock buyback to date, but it's definitely something on the radar for us. We're always looking at ways to utilize and allocate our capital to provide shareholder return that, maximizes it for them. And so this could be one of those ways.
Well, congrats again on this first quarter. What else can we expect from Harbor Custom? What's next?
I expect to continue to benefit from the stable pricing in our markets and taking advantage of the low inventory levels. We'll continue to serve multiple segments of the home buying market with our distinct business plan, targeting strong economies and growth markets located within a 20 to 60 minute commute of some of the major urban job corridors. We're going to continue to do our single family residential projects. And beyond that, we're going to continue building and selling townhomes, condominiums, and apartments. And we are already building those as we speak, and we'll continue to do that throughout 2022. And then based on the current market conditions and the status of our active projects, we are reiterating our 2022 revenue guidance of approximately $160 million and our adjusted EBITDA guidance of approximately $20
million. All right. Congratulations again. Good to see you, Lance. Thanks so much.
Yep. Thank you. Good to see you, Christine.